I'm going to start on the feeders. I'm going to put them in the water, and I'm going to do the same thing and let them soak in the bleachy water for about 10 minutes. And then I'm going to scrub them clean and then rinse them just like this and let them dry in the sun. When you're washing your jay feeders, a lot of them has this little lip right here. It helps to keep the rabbits from scratching the feed out. It doesn't necessarily cure the problem, but it does help. You want to make sure you clean underneath that lip, and then you want to make sure your brush can get into the corners of the inside, and of course scrub your screen from the inside and out. Now while you're cleaning your feeders is a good time to check and make sure your screen is in good shape and the feeder is in good condition and doesn't need to be replaced or repaired. This one appears to be in a good working condition. Now I did notice one of these when I pulled it out. The dough had scratched the screen here, and so there's a little hole that pellets are probably going to start falling out of pretty soon. So this weekend, hopefully the vendor will have a couple of extra feeders. I usually keep some extra just for that purpose. That way when I find one that needs to be replaced, I don't have to go somewhere to pick it up. I have some to spare. But I don't have any this size to spare. I have some of the bigger ones, but they don't fit in these cages, so I'm going to have to buy a couple this size. I'm going to go ahead and continue scrubbing the cages. And these feeders, I can only do two feeders at a time in this bucket, so I'll finish that up. Alright, so I'm down to, I got two feeders soaking. I got two left to do, and I got four out in the sun. I don't want to start cleaning cages or nest boxes or anything like that until all my feed and water bowls are done. I'm going to reuse that water. Today I only have one bucket. If I had another bucket, you could do it simultaneously, but since I only have one bucket today, I'm having to share. And so, what I'm going to do is start collecting my nest boxes, and most of those I have up here. I have 8 does bred, I have 8 does do. I need 8 nest boxes, so we're going to go ahead and start collecting the nest boxes. I need to look for scrap pegboard, yes. Well, we're on the downhill slide. We're getting there. My feeders, all my water bowls are clean. Oh, I got the last two feeders soaking. So while they're soaking, I'm going to start brushing these down to get down, get off all the loose fur and the loose hay and the dirt and the grime. Just brush that off so that it looks, you know, cleaner. That way when we get the cleaning stuff, you're not dirtying up your water with unnecessary fur and hay. And you're already breaking some of that old stuff off. Get these brushed down. Off and out, especially along these corners where bacteria like to hide. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and brush these down, and then I'm going to wash my last two feeders. So now that all my cages are cleaned and they've been rinsed, they're drip drying now, I'm going to go ahead and start putting the feeders and waterers back in. All nice and clean. Boy, too bad I couldn't afford to put all brand new shiny feeders back on. I love brand new shiny feeders. These are all several years old, but most of them are still in good shape. I do have to replace one every once in a while, just like this week. I've got, I think I saw two I need to replace. So I'm going to buy two new ones. Actually, I'm going to buy four new ones. That way, you know, I have to do all this again in 3 weeks. Because I got 8 more doughs bred in 8 weeks, so, or for 3 more weeks. So, I'm going to go ahead and have 2 extras, just in case I need to replace some more. So, alright, so these 2 are done. I'm going to go ahead and put the others back on, and we'll go to the next step. Alright, so everything is cleaned and washed, and the water bowls are put back, the feeders are put back. Now we do the nest box. While those, the cages are still drying, they're not quite dry yet, and they're working on it. While they're still drying, I'm going to start cleaning my pegboard floors and my cages. And I want to clean these first. So we're just going to go ahead in this bleachy soap water. Now you don't want to soak these because these pegboards will absorb water and then they'll warp and then get soft. The rabbits already chew on them, but if they were softer, they do so even easier. So you just want to clean them quickly with just enough water to get them clean and let the water run off while you're cleaning. Go, and where'd I put my rinse bucket? I lost my rinse bucket. Oh, here it is, over here. So I'm going to go ahead and rinse this, and again, you want it to run off. You don't want to soak your board. There we go. Now we'll put this to dry. Okay, now typically you want to do all those first. I'm just going to make this one section, so I'm going to go ahead and clean one of the nest boxes while we're at it. And we're going to do the same thing. You've already done most of the work with your scrub brush before you got the soap and water. So now you want this soap and water to clean whatever troubled spots you have, but mainly to sanitize and disinfect your nest box on the inside. And you really want to get these corners. And then you want to rinse it. And then set it in the sun to dry. Okay, so 7 more to go. All right, so all the cleaning is done. It's all done. The cages should be dry, or at least dry enough for now. The nest boxes are still a little wet. Now you can see the first ones I done are almost dry. These still need a little more time. So I'm going to go ahead and start putting these dolls back in their cages now. Hello, ladies. Are you ready to go back home? Alright, let's see. Who do we have? Are you Everlong? Yes, you're Everlong. Come on. Oh, good girl. Let's take you back home, huh? Miss the Queen is ready to go back also, won't you, girl? Huh? Come on. Oh, yeah, come on. Come on, Mama girl. She's a good girl. Yes, you are a good girl. All right, so now it's time to prepare the nest boxes, and this is what I'm going to do. Over here I have a container of wood chips, and I put about an inch of wood chips into the bottom of the nest box. There we go. This will absorb any moisture and for the most part keep the floor of the nest box as clean as possible. Okay, after the wood chips, you want to pack this full of hay. And what this is just mixed grass hay. my feed store, when they have bales of hay that burst and fall, I go and I get it, and they don't charge me for it. So this is free hay, and it's great for nest box material. Okay, nest boxes are done. Let's put it in with Mom. Here you go, Everlong. How about a fresh, clean nest box? Oh. Here you go. It's coming in. Here we go. Come on. Come this way. There we go. There we go. Let's see if she takes interest in it right away. Yes, I think she is. So is Shawnee. She's interested in chewing the hay. And, you know, I may have to replenish the hay before the kits are born, and that's okay. They'll scratch it out, and they'll rearrange it, and they'll stash it. And right before the kits are due, the night before, we may have to put a little more hay in there, and that's okay. All right, girls. Seven more to go. Okay, the last thing I want to do for these girls today is their name tags are all nice and shiny. So I'm going to write their names on their cage. So that's it for nest box day. Everyone is clean and nest box and ready to have their babies. They're all happily munching on hay, even their neighbors. Anyway, I've got to clean all this up. I've got to feed and water, and then I have to load up rabbits for the show tomorrow. So thanks for watching. If you've liked this video or found any use of it at all, please hit that thumbs up button. And if you don't want to miss the baby watch videos coming up in just a couple of days, be sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already done so. I'd also like to invite you to come on over to Facebook to either my personal web page or the Grace Hollow Rabbitry fan page, either one. And I've also recently started a show result blog, which can be found on my Weebly website. I will have links to all three of those pages down below in the description box. Be sure to check us out. Come say hello. And hey, if you're going to be in Duncan, Oklahoma this weekend, come on over and shake my hand and say hello. Thanks for watching, and until we speak again, God bless.